quantity algebraic expression.
Examples of crops that we grow in Zambia and the like.
Look at the algebraic expression.
Examples of crops that we grow in Zambia and the like.
Look at the algebraic expression.
Examples of crops that we grow in Zambia and the like.
Look at the algebraic expression.
Good afternoon, learners. Welcome to your integrated science lesson. My name is Miss Lessa. I'll be taking you in integrated science. So our first topic in grade 8, integrated science, is the human body. And under the human body, we had reproduction as our subtopic. And then we were going to be looking at fertilization and puberty before schools closed. So today we'll have a recap on reproduction, and for today, we are going to be identifying the organs of the reproductive systems in human, and then we will also define the functions or explain the functions of the parts or the organs that we are going to identify today. So reproduction, we said that human beings die. Human beings are not immortal, and because they tend to die, there is a need for them to procreate. So reproduction is the process by which human beings make other organisms, or organisms make other organisms like themselves. It's a process by which new organisms are formed by pre-existing organisms. So, reproduction we see that re here is a prefix, and production is a word which stands for the meaning of making. Production means simply making something, and re means is a prefix that stands for the word again. So this means again, and this means making. So from this you can understand that reproduction is the process by which organisms make more organisms like themselves. So it's making organisms again. So reproduction is the process by which organisms make more organisms like themselves. All right, so before we go any further, we are talking about the human body. So in this case, I have said it's the process by which organisms make more organisms like themselves. Now, a human being is an organism. So human beings, like many other organisms, produce sexually. So reproduction can be either sexually or asexually. But because we are looking at the human body, we are going to look at sexual reproduction. What is sexual reproduction? So sexual reproduction is the fusion or the joining together of the male sex cell, which we call the sperm, and the female sex cell. The joining of the male sex cell and the female sex cell, which is also called the ova, or I think this is too small, or egg. All right. So sexual reproduction is the joining of the male sex cell, which is called a sperm, and a female sex cell, which we call an ova or an egg, meaning that human beings, like many other organisms, have two types of sexual reproduction. They have two types of sexual reproduction systems. A system is a group of organs that work together to perform a specific function. A system is a group of organs working together to perform a specific function. So when I say the reproduction system, I simply mean that organs are working together to perform a reproductive role in the body. It can be a digestive role in the body, so meaning we'll talk about the digestion system. It can be a circulatory role in the body. We are talking about the circulatory system. But in this case, we are looking at reproduction. So we are talking about reproduction organs in the body. So we have a female reproductive system and a male reproductive system. So I have said that now the joining of the male sex cell and the female sex cell, meaning that the female reproductive system, organs from there are joining with organs in the male reproductive system to perform a specific function, which is called reproduction. So we expect to have organs in the male and in the female. Now, when these two join together, we call it sexual reproduction. But when they fuse to form a zygote, that process is called fertilization. So, get me right, fusion and joining together are two different things. When I say I am joining with someone, we are not fusing, we are simply going to be in the same place together. But when you fuse with someone, it means you are combining, you are sharing information with that person, you are together with that person. In short, for example, if you look at your mom and your dad, those two, even the Bible says when two people come together, they become one. So that is a fusion. Marriage is a fusion. But when you have a boyfriend, which you're not supposed to have in grade 8, that is just joining. Thank you. So fertilization is the fusion of the sperm and the ova or egg. So Instead of saying the male sex cell, I've gone directly to say the sperm, because we know that the sperm is the male sex cell. So the sex cell, the cell that we need for reproduction from the male is called the sperm. And the cell that we need for reproduction from the female is called an egg. So we are now going to identify, when these two fuse together, they form what we call a zygote. So to form a zygote. Sorry, I didn't finish this sentence. To form a zygote. All right. So we have said two cells are joining together to form a zygote, a sperm and an ova. Now when this zygote is formed, it is simply a cell which has the ability to develop into a baby, okay? And there are many stages in the womb. Of course, we know that it is our mothers who carry children, not our fathers, because the female reproductive system is also important because it develops the baby. It is our mothers who carry children. So it is a female reproductive system in which babies are protected, or rather cells, the zygote is protected and developed. So in short, there's an importance for this reproductive system. What is the importance of a reproduction system? Reproduction systems are important because they produce organs for reproduction. So if it is a male reproduction system and they ask you the importance, it produces a sperm. It produces the sperm which is used to form a zygote. The female, it produces an ova or an egg which is used for reproduction. And it is also the system in which babies develop. All right, so we are going to identify from here, we are going to identify first the organs found in a male reproductive system. And with me, I have a chart for the male reproductive system. As you can see here, I have a chart with me, the male reproductive system. This is the front view of the male reproductive system. Front view is simply how you are looking at me. This is my front view. This is my side view. And here we have a side view of a male. And from this point of view, he is standing the same way that I am standing. In short, we are standing parallel to each other. The way you are seeing me, we assume this is a male internal organs view, okay? So the way you are seeing me on this side, but of my reproductive system, this is the male's side view. So we are going to look at the main organs for reproduction. So first and foremost, the bladder is not an organ of reproduction. I emphasize, the bladder is not an organ for reproduction. It is simply there for view, that it is through which urine comes from. So when you look at a urinary system in the body, you talk about the bladder. So for me, the organs, the main organs that we are going to talk about today, and I'm sure you looked at in your first term of grade 8, are the penis, which is very visible to you as a male child, and the scrotum, the testis, the epididymis, sperm duct, and urethra. So on your body, I'm sure the only things that you can view are the scrotum and the penis. But the other ones are internal organs. You cannot see them. They are inside your body. So we are going to now define or explain their functions. Having identified them, we can now go into functions of the male reproductive systems. So maybe we can tabulate this so that we are quite clear on what we are looking at. Let's make a table. All right, so organs of the male reproductive system, or let us say male reproductive system organs. Main organs of the male reproductive system. main organs of the male reproductive system. So here we are going to put organ. And we can go down to functions on this side of our table. All right. So the first one, like I said, the penis is your main organ of reproduction. I mean, what you use to urinate. Boys, my boys, or is it you do? There's no man in grade 8, so we are talking to, I'm talking to boys and girls. So boys, your penis, what you use to urinate, that is a penis. It is also a reproductive system. I mean, it's also an organ of the reproductive system. So, what is the function of the penis in reproduction? What is the function of the penis? So, this one penetrates into the vagina of a woman during sexual intercourse. When I talk, sexual intercourse is also known as copulation. In short, this is the penetration of the penis into a woman's vagina or a female vagina, which you are going to see when we look at the female reproductive system. So it penetrates. The female vagina, okay, during sexual intercourse. Okay, great. So it penetrates. When it penetrates, what is it that it penetrates for? Because it carries sperms, so it's going to ejaculate sperms when it penetrates during sexual intercourse. When this penis penetrates in the vagina of a woman, it will ejaculate sperms. But we'll talk about that process under fertilization, which we are going to come to after identifying and giving the function. So for function's sake, let's just say it penetrates the female vagina during sexual intercourse. What about the scrotum? So as you can see, the scrotums are ball-like structures. Actually, when you're speaking in a layman's terms, we just call them balls. I've heard people say balls. These, they are ball-like structures that hold the testis. So their function is to hold the testis. Now, let me emphasize a very important point. Have you noticed that the scrotum are outside your body? Apart from the penis, which I said is visible to you, the scrotum are also outside your body. It's not an internal organ, it's outside the body. You can see it when you look at yourself. This is because sperm production does not take place at body temperature. It needs a lower temperature than the body temperature for it to happen. So the scrotum hang outside the body so that they cool the testis for sperm production. I repeat, the scrotum hang outside the body so that they are able to cool the body temperature for sperm production to take place. Because sperm production does not take place at the same temperature as the body. It requires a cooler temperature than the body temperature. So they hold the testis outside the body. Okay. The testis. What is the function of the testis? What is the function of the testis? As you can see, this testis, this is where sperms are produced. In short, sperms are produced in the testis. That is where sperm production takes place. So the function of the testis is for sperm production. Okay. Epididymis or epididymas. What is the function of the epididymis? So that I don't confuse you, let me just draw a line. So the epididymis stores sperms. They are tube-like structures where sperms are stored temporarily before sexual intercourse. So when the male or when the testis, when the male reproductive system produces sperms, which happens in the testis like we have mentioned earlier, they are temporarily stored in the epididymis before being transported to the sperm duct and then to the penis for penetration, or rather for ejaculation into the female vagina. They are stored temporarily in the epididymis. So it stores sperms. Temporarily before sexual intercourse. But during, when sexual intercourse is happening, they come out of their storage or their comfort zone and are transported through the sperm duct. So the sperm duct transports, it's a tube-like structure, so it transports sperms from the testis to where the urethra, as you can see the movement, it's coming like this. So production, storage, transportation, and out ejaculated through the urethra to the urethra. Sorry? To the urethra. Okay, what is the function of the urethra? It is simply the pathway of sperms out into a woman's vagina. So from the sperm duct, they're still moving. This is also a pathway. So it is a pathway through which sperms are ejaculated. It is a pathway through which sperms are ejaculated into the female vagina. So it is still a tube-like structure and they are still being transported. After being transported from the testis, they run through the sperm duct and now they are going out. Into a female's vagina. So these, for this level, are the main male reproductive organs. The main male reproductive organs. So let's just take a quick recap of the organ and its functions. The testis, it produces sperms, like I have emphasized. This is where sperms are produced. They are temporarily stored in the epididymis before being transported to the sperm duct. So they are temporarily stored here, but when sexual intercourse is taking place, they run through the sperm duct, which transports them from the testis to the urethra. Now the urethra is inside the penis. It is the open tube in the penis, which when penetration takes place into the woman's vagina, ejaculates the sperms out into the woman's vagina. So the transport system is like this: from the testis to the sperm duct, down through the urethra, and the urethra is found in the penis. So the penis is what penetrates, but what ejaculates them out is the small tube inside the penis called the urethra. This is also a urinary system, but this system is closed during sexual intercourse so that you do not urinate in a woman's vagina. That is why it is impossible for a man's reproductive system to urinate in a woman's vagina, because the urinary system is closed during sexual intercourse. The reproduction system is open. All right, so we move on to a female's reproductive system. Let's now identify the main organs of the female reproductive system and give their functions. Let's explain their functions as well. So I have another chart. Female reproductive system. And here we only have a side view. But in this case, the man was standing like this. But in this case, our lady is standing the way I am standing. My fellow woman is standing like this. So you are identifying the reproductive systems on this side view. All right. So we'll talk about the main reproductive organs in a female. I think we can even use this table. Hope you are taking note of the previous functions. For the sake of time, we use our already drawn table. Right. Main organs of the female. Take note that our table has changed. We are now looking at the female reproductive system. Main organs of the female reproductive system. So in the female reproductive system, you can see that we have a vagina. That is why I said that human beings have two systems. They have two different systems. Their systems differ. So the male and female reproductive systems differ. As you can see, even just the way you look at it, even when you look at yourself as a woman, you are different from a man. Or sorry, as a boy, you are different from a girl child, because your reproductive systems differ. A girl, instead of having a penis, she has a vagina. So we have a vagina, we have a cervix, we have a uterus, we have an ovary, and there is what we call the oviduct. So for the sake of reproduction, some of these labels like bladder do not apply. I'm going to write the main, the organs that are involved in reproduction. So whatever is on this chart that I don't put on this table is not a reproductive organ. I repeat, only the organs I'll put there are important for the process of reproduction. So let's start. The vagina. Okay. What is the function of this vagina? Now, I told you that I'll show you the vagina on the female reproductive system because my chart was on top of this one. So here, as you can see, it's like a pathway. So that penis that you saw penetrates this vagina during sexual intercourse. It enters in here during sexual intercourse. So the vagina receives the penis. During sexual intercourse. So when it receives this penis, the penis is going to ejaculate sperms into it. Okay? When it receives this penis, I mean when it receives the penis that we saw on our previous chart, it enters through here. It's going to ejaculate sperms through the from the penis's urethra, the sperms will move out and enter into this female reproductive system through this vagina. It is also a pathway or a birth canal through which a child is born. So when a child has been developed in the womb of a woman, like I said, Our mothers are the ones who carry babies in the womb. So when a baby has been developed, when the baby develops in this uterus and it's time for the child to come out, the baby has saved the pregnancy time. The baby has developed according to the time that it takes for that specific organism to develop a child, and the time of labor has come. It is the vagina that is the pathway for the child to come out. So it also serves as the pathway. For childbirth. Okay. It is a pathway for childbirth. What about the cervix? So let's take it upwards in this system. We're going like this. Okay. This is the lower end of the uterus. It is a lower narrow end of the uterus. This is simply an entry point. It is just this part. So it's the lower end of the uterus which closes during pregnancy. Okay? Why does it close during pregnancy? We don't want whatever contents are in here to be coming out. And those contents that I'm talking about during pregnancy are the child, the developing fetus. When I say fetus, it is simply the second stage through which the zygote undergoes. Like I said, when the sperm and the ova fuse together, they form a zygote. That zygote stays in here, develops into a fetus, and then lastly, it develops into a baby which will come out. So when there is a baby in here, if we open this cervix, the baby will come out, and we call that miscarriage. Okay, so we don't want to have a miscarriage when people are pregnant. They don't want to have a miscarriage. We want to have a baby. And so scientifically, this cervix closes during pregnancy. So it's the narrow. End of the uterus. Which closes during pregnancy. Okay, it closes during pregnancy. So if it closes when there's a baby here, what happens when there is no baby? When there is no baby, sexual intercourse happens for reproduction sake, like we have said. So it opens so that the sperm can swim all the way to go and fuse with the ova. Where does this fusion take place? Sorry, I'll skip the uterus for now. Let's go to the oviduct. This oviduct is also called a fallopian tube. As you can see, it looks like a tube. It is a tube. It is a tube. And we know that tubes are pathways. So, from the vagina, the sperm swims through the uterus and goes into the oviduct. This is seen clearly on a front view chart or on a front view of the female reproductive system. This one doesn't show you clearly, but we'll look at it next time, because it's going to be an exercise for you. So the sperm will swim from this vagina through this uterus into the oviduct, okay? Now it is in this oviduct where fertilization takes place. So I said tubes are where things move or things are transported. So this, the egg, for the egg, it's transported through the oviduct from the ovaries to the uterus. So it transports. It has two functions, this oviduct. Transports the egg. Okay, sorry, let me just make it clear for you. It transports the egg from the ovaries to the uterus. Now, it is through this process of transporting it, while it is coming, it will meet the sperm here and fertilization will take place. So it is where, or it is the site where, a site is a location, so, or a position. So it's the position or the site where fertilization takes place. So like I said, this oviduct or fallopian tube has two functions. It transports the egg from the ovary to the uterus, and it is also the place where fertilization takes place. Fertilization is the fusion of the sperm and the ova. So they are going to fuse in this position, in this tube. That's where the sperm will fuse with the egg. So as the egg is moving, the egg will only move a short period of time, and the sperm will have already found it somewhere here for fusion to take place. Okay? And when they fuse now, they will form a zygote, which will move to the uterus and stay there for development. So in the oviduct, that's where the eggs are coming to. Where are they coming from? The ovary. What is the function of the ovary? For it is where eggs are produced. So the eggs are being produced here and they are moving down like this. That is why if the egg reaches here, we call it menstruation, because no fertilization has taken place anywhere. The egg has come out without meeting any sperm, and that is menstruation. That's what we are going to look at in our next topic, which is puberty. So for now, we know that the egg will move from the ovary down the oviduct through the uterus and through the vagina and come out as the blood which we see when we menstruate. Women, girls, we know that there is a process of menstruation which we'll look at when we look at puberty. But where, during reproduction, this egg is naturally supposed to meet, after sexual intercourse, it's supposed to meet a sperm and fertilization is supposed to take place. So this is where the production of eggs takes place. Okay. So having looked at that, now we'll look at the uterus. And I have already mentioned that when fertilization takes place in the oviduct, the zygote that is formed during fertilization moves to the uterus for development. So the uterus, this is where the developing young is kept and protected. Okay. This is where the developing young, when I say developing young, I simply mean the zygote, which will develop into a baby. Because we said a zygote is a cell which has the ability to develop into a baby. So this is where a baby is stored, in the uterus. So when you see mommy is pregnant, or any person that is pregnant, it means they are carrying a baby in their uterus, okay? That is why it is also called a womb. I'm sure you are familiar with the term womb. The uterus is also called a womb. Okay. All right. So, having identified and explained the functions of reproduction, next time we'll be looking at we'll be looking at fertilization and puberty. And I've said under puberty we will look at menstruation. So for now, our lesson is done. I'll leave you with an exercise, and maybe if there are questions, the number to call, today we are not receiving calls, the number that you are texting for questions is 09. For SMS, 0977 728000. So this is the number that you can contact me on, and I can receive questions starting from now till the next 10 minutes. I think I still have 10 minutes with you. So I'll be receiving questions from now. So exercise. Not taking calls today. We are not taking calls, but you can SMS us or drop a comment on Facebook. And we have pages on the Mubuyu page, the Fountain Gate page, and the Goka page. Okay. So here, question one, I want you to draw the front view. Of the female reproductive system and explain its functions. Okay. For the second question, we are going to explain why the scrotum hung outside the body. Okay, so I've already given you this. I want you to research and give me a drawing of the front view of the female reproductive system, and you can explain why the scrotum hung outside the body. I think for this one we have talked about it. So I'll be taking questions, and I'm seeing that I've been receiving a lot of calls. I'm receiving SMS questions. Wow. I have a lot of calls. Maybe you can text me. I can see a text quicker. Okay. Oh, okay. I'm seeing more of comments than questions. So, thank you for your comments. Thank you for attending the lesson. Maybe we can check questions. Oh, someone is asking, does fertilization only take place in the fallopian tube? Yes. For grade 8, this is the site where fertilization takes place. I know in higher level, they'll tell you that it can take place in the uterus, but fertilization takes place in the oviduct or in the fallopian tube. I repeat, this is the site where fertilization takes place, the oviduct or the fallopian tube. Thank you. People are trying to call. Okay. There are too many mess. Okay. Someone is saying, why do women vomit when they are pregnant? Unfortunately, we are not looking at pregnancy. We are looking at reproduction. So if you ask me about this, the organs and the stages of puberty, we are looking at reproduction, fertilization, and puberty. Okay? We'll be looking at reproduction, fertilization, and puberty. So that topic is out of context. Let's skip that question. Thank you. So next time we will look at reproduction in detail and puberty. Thank you for coming through. Till next time.
Good afternoon, class. And these are examples of crops that we grow in Zambia and the life.
Look at the algebraic expression.